Hi everyone, I'm Sloan from SloanBella.com and I'm back with another astrology video. This one is on the sign of Scorpio, the fixed water sign ruling the eighth house of the natural wheel of the zodiac. Now, what is another word for fixed? Another word for fixed is, I know I'm right, I'm never changing my mind, do as I say, not as I do, shut up, I'm right. That's a Scorpio attitude, only they're much more secretive about it. But another word for fixed is stubborn or unwavering. Fixed, they have a fixed opinion. And Scorpio is a water sign, so their opinions are drawn from the undercurrents that exist around them. Now, the eighth house of the natural wheel of the zodiac is the house that is pertaining to other people's money, more importantly, to sex, death, and regeneration. So the eighth house is where we will see mediumship gifts expressed. If you have a loaded eighth house, planets in the eighth house, a Scorpio moon, a Scorpio sun, or a Scorpio rising. If you have other planets in your eighth house, this gives us a little bit of an idea into what you keep transforming in this life. The eighth house is extremely transformative. And as such, Scorpio carries that burden. Now, as you guys know, the symbol for Scorpio is the scorpion with its little tail, with its spike on the end that basically will take you out in 2 seconds with its venomous poison that comes out of its tail when it stings you. In other words, you pretty much know when you've been iced by a Scorpio. Now, they don't all present themselves that way because Scorpio owns the ability, more so than any other sign, to really transform itself through different energy phases. We have the scorpion, and let me give you an idea of the people that would resonate on that scorpionic vibration. So the first mascot for Scorpio, you would have people that you see, okay, we'll put it in the movies, your bar people, your really, really dark addicts that hang out in corners and bars and after hours clubs, the gambling, the prostitution, the pimps, the drug dealing, El Chapo, any however you want to look at it, very scorpionic in the lower vibration of Scorpio, or the beginning of the transformation. It's not really lower, it's just the beginning of understanding what you're here to do and what you can utilize with the energy. That's where we get the mob from. The mob is very scorpionic in its energy. The old style mob back in the day in the 40s, it was a very Scorpio enterprise. It was like, we're gonna come, we're gonna take money from you, we're gonna run girls, gamble, drugs, and you're gonna pay us for protection, and we'll kill anyone that bugs you as long as you pay us and we don't kill you. So that's the beginning. Now, what is the second mascot for Scorpio? The second energy of Scorpio is that of the gray lizard. And the gray lizard is one of my favorite animals. I used to have some as pets when I was younger because they were so cute, and they escaped anyway because you can't really cage them. They can get through the little things. I thought I would try. Anyway, the lizard is the one that sits in the middle of the desert, high up on a rock, looking for sun, right? Observing everything, not doing anything, not interfering, not harming, just being extremely aware, acutely aware of the energies that go on around it, so that it gathers information through observation and can make energetic choices based on that. So that is the second phase of Scorpio, the one that doesn't comment, doesn't feel a need to strike back, but basically wants to absorb the atmosphere, the undercurrent of energy that exists around us. So the lizards are very, very spiritual animals. I'm sure they are listed somewhere as that. I don't actually know that to be true. However, I do know through the Scorpio sense, they are extremely spiritual because they are the keepers of the information, although they're quiet about it. So you never hear a lizard, well, I don't know how to speak lizard, but you never hear them going around. Like, they're not the ones that you really see scattering in danger, but they are the ones that are watching what that danger is. And they have a basic understanding in every area about what's going on. So it's a highly intuitive and productive part of the Scorpio energy. This is when you have people that work in management positions where they are acutely aware of everything needed and gathered in order to facilitate the success of another person. You will also notice at this phase of the Scorpio energy, people who can take money and triple it because they are aware of what to do with it. I know that's a nice gift, right? There's a downside to that too with Scorpio, because Scorpio has this thing where they like, you know, get rich quick schemes, and that can be problematic at times if they pick the wrong scheme to get rich at. So they can be easily led into things like Ponzi schemes if they're not careful, if they're not really observant, just by the fact that they're looking to transform their financial status. I know we all are, but for Scorpio, that's a thread through their existence, the money thing. They will always speak about money and what to do with it and how to acquire it and how to shift the energy of finances into how they need to portray it. So it's an interesting thing. They have a very, very acute intuition. Now, when you go from that part of Scorpio and you jump up and you go into the really transformative part of Scorpio, which is the Phoenix rising from the ashes. So basically, these are the Scorpio people, for example, get into a normal, regular Joe that gets into a car accident, who loses function of both his legs, can't drive, breaks his back, is bedridden for 5 years, and then suddenly, through everything, works through it, transforms, and becomes even better than he was before the accident, is able to do that somehow. That's the regenerative process and the third level of Scorpio. Scorpio is really transcendental and goes through several phases in a lifetime. So the ending phase, or the resurrection phase of Scorpio, it sounds almost Christ-like. You are martyred and tortured, you are observant, and you come back and you facilitate growth in a positive way. That is basically Scorpio's energy. But again, I still say you got to watch out for their stingers, because their stingers live, whether they live verbally, whether they live physically, but they live. If you live with people with Scorpio sun, moon, or rising, you know exactly what I'm talking about. They will never speak first. They keep it all in. They will tell you what they want you to know in order to present the facade that they need to, or they will not speak at all if they are in the middle energies by degree of Scorpio, because they don't want to say things that aren't true. They have an integrity about them, so they're just not going to speak, rather than, so they'll walk out of a room, you ask them a question that they don't want to answer, and it's like, bye-bye Scorpio, they're not going to answer it, because they just, their integrity won't allow it. Now, Scorpio's ruling planet is so expressive of this energy. Ruling planet is Pluto. Pluto is terrifying to astrologers 99% of the time. I don't mind it and I don't like it. So I try to stay neutrally detached from it so that I don't draw it to me. This is my new theory. Ignore it, acknowledge and disconnect neutrally so that you have no attachment to it. Pluto in your chart, wherever it's placed, whether it be in your first house, second, third, fourth, fifth, and as it's transiting through your chart, it will bring upheaval with it. It correlates with the tower in the tarot deck. The tower is thrown out when there's times of huge change. Now, what is change? The fires that we had in Northern California and Malibu were really Plutonian to me. And they were actually started by the natural gas company, PG&E up north, and GE Electric in Malibu. So that's even more Plutonian, if you will. But it was very, very much a symbol of Pluto. In other words, the life was going along great as planned. Everybody was doing what they were supposed to be doing. And suddenly, literally, their lives are burnt to the ground in 5 seconds, and they're left having to resurrect themselves, and they will never be the same from that, because they don't, everything that they were does not exist. Even if they have the money to put it back, does it go back the same, or is something missing from the experience? So it's really interesting. That is a Scorpio energy, especially a Plutonian, or its ruling planet of Pluto. So when you're looking at Scorpio, the very fixed and stubborn water sign, whose opposition is Taurus, I'm making the Taurus horns, 6 months across in the calendar year is the fixed earth sign. So the two of them go in tandem with their expression. Taurus is the very practical builder, whereas Scorpio extends that out and harnesses the energy that is unseen. What is not seen below the surface? What can you not see? Another very Scorpio energy is the things that we deal with in life and death and birth and rebirth. So I have actually met, weirdly in my profession, two Scorpios that were actually makeup artists in a mortician in the morgue. I have met a few of them, more than a few of them, that were massage therapists because they're going to work with the energy of the hands. And I've met many sex workers with Scorpio energy, meaning sun, moon, or rising. And again, look in your chart and see where Scorpio is placed. That is where you have a high drive to find the truth. Scorpio is a detective and will not let anything go until they know what it is they're looking for. So if you tell a lie to a Scorpio, you're basically giving them the go-ahead to go through everything they can to prove to you that you are lying to them, because they can feel it. So if you lie to them, watch out, because that nothing sets them off more than that. They go nuts and they will stalk you and hunt you and find out what you're lying about. Even if it's your own surprise party, their own surprise party, they will do that. So the Scorpio energy is extremely intense. It is also, in the strongest sense, peaceful when it reaches the higher octaves. In other words, it has a fluidity with everything that lives and everything that is around us. So in its transformation from the lower levels to the higher levels, there is a strong observance of all things are equal and peaceful in life and we are all attached. So Scorpio is extremely good at expressing that energy. Hopefully, oh, before I go, Scorpio's ruling body parts are the reproductive organs, both male and female. There are different offshoots. Scorpio also is the regenerative part of the body. What goes in must come out. So the actual bathroom functions are run by Scorpio and Virgo. Virgo in the intestines, Scorpio with the elimination process. And you have the reproductive area. So the genital area is run by Scorpio. So in the chart, if the Scorpio parts of your chart are afflicted or they are transiting with negative aspects at the time, you can develop issues in that area if you go to an astrologer and you have them read the progressions of the chart. This is just your basic astrology and your basic Scorpio astrology, Scorpio 101. But Scorpio on a whole, if you're in for an intense transformative time and you want the truth, and if you ask them, how do I look in this or how does this sound, they'll definitely tell you the truth. And if they are angry at you, they'll throw a little stinger in there with it. But for the most part, Scorpio and its regeneration of energy is amazing. Once again, my name is Sloan.